political segment House of Cards makes a comeback as Murimi Mwangi interrogates Ruto's remaining options in the 2022 race to State House.
Eldoret Town at the peak of the 2017 presidential campaigns, and it might have appeared as a done deal to isolate ODM leader Raila Odinga as the one unwanted man anywhere near the house on the hill. Or perhaps a sealed 20-year Jubilee pact, 10 of these under a William Ruto presidency, after President Uhuru Kenyatta's projected 2022 exit.
Tumalize hii miaka mitano jameni, mimi niende nipumzike, Ruto ashikilia sukume huko mbele.
But perhaps not anymore, as Ruto slowly takes up the unwanted tag from right within his own Jubilee party, where the battle to kick him out has hit a fever pitch, the latest being a decision by the Jubilee National Management Committee, declaring the deputy president persona non grata at the Pangani-based party headquarters, a directive that now awaits a verdict of the President Kenyatta-chaired Jubilee National Executive Committee.
Hamwezi kunifukuza ODM.
But what options remain for Ruto in the battle for the party leadership and the eventual race to State House? While key Ruto men were recently axed from the National Executive Committee, having lost their house leadership slots in the National Assembly and the Senate, Ruto, by virtue of his post as deputy party leader, still sits in neck and would thus be present should Kenyatta convene the powerful organ, and is also entitled to defend himself against the gross misconduct claims recently unleashed by the party's management committee. Still, any decision to eject Ruto from the powerful post, should the party's neck resolve as such, would also be open to further litigation in court. Yet the raging campaign to block Ruto's accession to the presidency, analysts argue, appears to be playing into the deputy president's sympathy card through the narrative of being isolated from the same government he co-founded. Some critics, such as former vice president and ANC party leader Musalia Mudavadi, now challenging Ruto to resign over his supposed violation of the principle of collective responsibility that binds him to the policies and decisions of the same government he claims to be isolated from.
They want to have their cake and eat it. They are trying to turn it around and make it look like the problem is Uhuru's and not theirs. This was a Jubilee government. It is a Jubilee government.
People underestimate the hustler movement in this country. And they actually underestimate the feelings of many Kenyans about the perceived betrayal of the deputy president, whether they perceive it as betrayed by his boss or that by the government itself, that he worked so hard to fight for it.
Jubilee has already entered a post-election coalition agreement with the Senator Gideon Moi-led KANU Party, with Wiper leader Kalonzo Musyoka also on course to formalize his cooperation with Jubilee into a coalition agreement. Ruto's troubles already complicated by key Kenyatta allies, such as the party's vice chair David Murathe, openly campaigning for ODM leader Raila Odinga's presidency in 2022. The deputy president, a known fighter and fierce stickler of the defiance card, lately concentrating his efforts in a grassroots popularization drive anchored on his now famous Hustlers movement, through which Ruto hopes to defy any boardroom-generated Kenyatta succession roadmap that isolates him.
In politics generally, the only consideration is interests. Those who are exiting the presidential, you know, seat, they are looking at who will protect their interests better. And sometimes it's not even about the person who is exiting as the president. It is about the people who have been holding that presidency.
This is not about the deputy president being isolated or anything. It is about the rule of law. We have got a habit in this country that we need to deal with, and we want to start dealing with it in Jubilee. whereby we form political parties, then we make them personal properties, and we always kill democracy.
Nobody is saying that the deputy president should not be contesting. In fact, a lot of people are relishing that contest against him because they have loads and loads of stuff on him, which they are willing and ready and waiting to unleash.
Mimi nitashindana na wale watakuwa ndani ya Jubilee, na mimi niko tayari. Kama Jubilee itaamua mtu mwingine kupitia kwa njia ya demokrasia, mimi niko tayari kuunga huyo mwingine mkono.
Nevertheless, a single day, they say, is a long time in politics. And Ruto certainly remains the man to beat in the Kenyatta succession race.
A thick skin, they say, is a mandatory armor in the murky world of politics. But with a growing anti-Ruto rhetoric, the DP no doubt has to review his strategies as the 2022 political drumbeats intensify. Murimi Mwangi, KTN News, in Nairobi.